Good morning, students. I am Neet. 28 years of experience in chemistry teaching. So my aim is to support the students those are preparing for NEET, IIT and JEE. So now regarding chemistry, so what is the thing is required is you have to do lot of previous year courses. If you are doing each subject previous year courses, mean definitely the each subject have 2 or 3 courses mean. So totally we have some 10 courses mean. The time saved at the exam form will be there. So my first sincere advice is you practice lot of previous year courses. Okay, with that, let me go to the program. For coming the month of January, February, March or April, till April, all the 4 months, my plan is to give daily the video tricks for the preparation of the NEET and IIT. So students, please subscribe my channel and up to and press the bell button. The daily portions videos will be reaching you for the best preparation. All the best. So now let us see the today's topic is redox reaction. Since the lesson is very important for inorganic as well as physical chemistry, from the lesson itself you can expect the 3 courses. So I am taking the first video show for the redox reaction. Okay, now let us see the redox reaction. The lesson is in the 3 categories. Redox reaction lesson, they will ask the question in 3 categories. One is just calculate the oxidation number of any compound. For this, simple rules are required. Of course, this thing I am not going to need out of what is for each at all. So, next one is you have to calculate the stoichiometry for balancing. Stoichiometry. So, this is the second method of questioning. Third one is structure based oxidation number. So, which requires a lot of tricks and the most important question. So, this is the area we are going to cover. And the fourth one is types of reaction. Types of reaction and calculate the N factor. Find out the equivalent weight. These are the next category of the questions we are expecting. So, this question is belonging to basic concept lesson also. So, now let us see today's concentration. Calculate the oxidation number based on the structure. So, let us see. The first one is what is the maximum oxidation number and minimum oxidation number for each group? So now, heading is calculate oxidation number on structure based. So that is very important, on structure based. So this is today's topic. Before going to this one, you should know the maximum and the minimum oxidation state. So what the knowledge is clear is maximum number and the minimum oxidation number for each group is important. So let us go to the trick for this one. So before that, let us write the group. 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. The family is called as a, the 13 is called as a boron family, carbon, nitrogen, fluorine, and this is the carbon, nitrogen, sorry, calories, oxygen, fluorine. So, its corresponding concentration is NS2NB1. Here it is NS2NB2, and here it is NS2NB3. Yes, next NS2NB4, and here NS2NB5. So, these are the their configuration. So, what is the next our aim is? What is maximum oxidation number and minimum oxidation number? Here, what is the maximum is? Let me write here. Maximum oxidation number is equivalent to valence electron. So, what is the valence electron here? 3. So, here 3.
and here it is 6, here it is 7. So next one is, what is minimum oxidation number? For the formula is valence electron minus 8. Keep it in the mind, valence electron minus 8. Here valence electron is 3 minus 8. So what is 8? Minus 5. So here 4 minus 8. So it is, let me remove this one. What is here? It is minus 4. And here 5 minus 8 minus 3. And here 6 minus 8 minus 2. And here 7 minus 8 minus 1. So these are the minimum oxidation number. So what is the next one is the range. Regarding here, minimum to maximum for this is minus 5 to 3. Minus 4 to 4. Minus 3 to 5. This is where the state is a 2. Don't take it as a minus. Yes. Here it is. Minus 2 to 6. Minus 1 to 7. Sorry, children. So with that, we have completed the minimum and the maximum oxidation state. So let us see the remaining part in the next video. Thank you, students.